All right, so here are some examples of how I give questions to a test that will kind of help to see if the kid knows what they're doing, and it takes the place of showing work, if you want to call it. When you multiply 34 times 56, get the first row of numbers. So I'm not asking for the answer. I'm asking for the first row of numbers because some kids don't do it correctly, or they cheat or whatever else. So whenever during COVID, this was very good to do because during COVID, you can't see if they're cheating or not. So when we're remote, this is a great problem. For 4 plus 4 divided by 4 plus 6 order of operation problem, what is the first step in solving the problem? You could do this by multiple choice. It could be A, 4 plus 4, 4 divided by 4, 4 plus 6. You could have a multitude, or you could say something like it doesn't matter. So if you design these questions correctly, you can really tell if the kids are learning. For a rectangle with a length of 6 and a width of 3, how would you solve for the area? So you're not actually solving for area. You're just saying, hey, how would you do it? And you could have answer choices: A, 6 plus 3, 6 times 3, 6 divided by 3, 6 plus 6 plus 6. So I give answer choices that are popular wrong answers that kids do. I don't ever give a throwaway question or a throwaway answer. I always try to make sure that the kids really know what they're doing. So these are examples of problems that I've done that show a kid's understanding, and it kind of takes the place of seeing those steps. All right, when I used to paper grade, I took an hour per class per test. And I usually, almost every year I've taught, I've had 5 classes. So that's 5 hours. And we're not talking 5 hours of getting a snack and getting a drink of water and that kind of stuff. It's 5 straight hours of grading. So usually I would do it on a Sunday. I would even go into school. I would dread Sundays because I would spend 5 to 6 to 7 hours grading. Especially if I'm watching TV, and of course you could say don't watch TV, but it's so boring to grade test. By the first quarter, in the first quarter, you already knew what the kids were going to get. The kids that worked hard and studied, you knew what their grade was going to be. The kids that slacked and didn't do anything, you knew what their grade was going to be. So I think time is wasted on paper grading. Turnaround time was usually a week or more with me. And unless you are Superman, where you can give a test on a Wednesday and grade it that night and give it back on Tuesday. If you can do that, that's amazing. Hats off to you. But most people have things going on in their lives that they just can't spend 4 to 5 hours grading tests that very night or even within a week. Think about you get a test on a Friday and you want to go hang out with your friends all weekend and have a trip, have a family trip. Guess what? You're on Sunday, got a pit in your stomach because you've got to grade those tests. So you put it off, you put it off. Week later goes by and kids are asking about the test. Parents are asking. Hard time keeping track of kids who are absent. So the biggest problem I had with paper grading is kids would be absent, and I knew it. But then the next day you wake up, and out of 100 kids I usually have every year, I can't remember. And yeah, I could look at my grade book, and they got lost in a shuffle. And sometimes kids just ended up not ever taking a test because I just forgot. Have to carry around all the papers, keep them separated. Doesn't seem like a big deal, but I would carry these plastic bins, and I would carry the papers home, and they'd fall apart in my car. They'd come home, and I'd have to, I don't know, it was just a pain to carry them around. One time my cat peed on them. Yeah, and the parents demanded the test, of course, and I had to spray the papers with some Lysol and stuff. But yeah, my cat took the bin that I had and used it as a litter box. Many times a kid is absent, and when I pass the test back, and by the time I got the test back to the kid, a couple of weeks have passed. So let's say a kid is absent on a Wednesday, you pass back the test on a Wednesday, they're not back till Monday of the next week. You forget about it that time. You have a special place you put to kids that are absent their test, and you forget about it. They forget about it, and then 2 weeks after the test was given, they finally get it back. They forgot the topic. They don't even know what they did. No name. No name on papers. Meant more time tracking it down. I would say out of 100 papers, I would have on average 10 not put their names on the paper. By the end of the year, you could whittle it down to 2 or 3. But you're still spending that extra time. Whose is this? Then there's 3 people absent that day in that class. So then you got to go to the class the next day and hold it up and say, whose is this? And then you can take off points, and then a parent gets mad because you take off 10 points because they don't put their name on it. It just got difficult. It just gets difficult. That's all. Hard to read handwriting. Can't tell you the number of times where a kid couldn't read their handwriting. And it was also, I thought it was a 5. The kid came back and said it was a 6. Who's right? Even if the kid didn't mean it to be a 6, they say it was because that was the right answer. I don't know. It just got to be too much of a debate and a fight. All right. So, All of this combined, I get the argument of math teachers want to show work. Math teachers want to see that work. I used to be like that. I've done this for over 30 years. And the first 10, 15 years, I said, got to show work. No math teacher would ever be a math teacher without work being shown. I give all online tests. I don't spend time grading. It's done instantaneously. I do spend a lot of time preparing for the test the first time, but then I can reuse the test for years later. I have my own program I've made with a programmer, and I have a database of questions, and I can have the program make the test for me, quizzes for me, homework for me. I don't have to grade it. Homework is graded online, tests are graded online, notebook quizzes are graded online. It's all done instantaneously, and I have a lot more free time, and I have more time to plan. And that's the biggest thing. I used to get sucked into not being able to plan. Now I've got plenty of time to plan. So I know there's going to be people out there that are traditional, with the paper, and I get that. But think about it. If you're an eighth grade teacher and you are given a test with slope and graphs, your test is probably about 3 to 4 pages long. So just the time it takes you to flip a page and grade it, flip a page and grade it, flip a page and grade it, takes time. That's a lot of time out of your day where my argument would be you could easily make an online test and give it, and it accomplishes the exact same goal. Now you might say, well, what about your test scores? Well, I've had exceeded growth every year except for maybe one, and maybe I think that was during the pandemic when we were hardly ever in class. They met growth, didn't exceed it. I've never had a year where I didn't meet growth, where I did not meet growth for my kids. My test scores are usually some of the highest in the school, if not the highest, usually. I see learning happening. I don't hear of the next year teacher saying the kids don't know this or know that. So I don't see any downside to online grading. Maybe the steps aren't followed as strictly. I think the kids that are going to get the steps and know them are going to do them anyways, because you're going to have to if you ask the right questions. So that's my take. Again, with the website that I've made along with my programmer, it's easy peasy. It's instantaneous feedback. The kids see it. The parents see it. It's time stamped. It tells you exactly how long a kid spends on each problem. It tells you how long a kid spent on the test. You could even let the kid finish it up at home if it was a kid with an IEP. So there's a lot of advantages to it that the paper copy doesn't give. Feel free to comment. Feel free to give me your take on this. Feel free to make a video and give me your take. I'm willing to listen. I guess I'm just at the age that I'm not willing to spend 5 to 7 hours grading every single test and then 2 hours or 3 hours grading quizzes. So let me know.